Do you want to know why I stopped making reaction videos and why most reactors need to stop making it as well? Why keep watching this video? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Tovia Ogun, and if you're new here, you're welcome to this amazing family. And if you're a returning Tovian, you are welcome. If you're yet to subscribe, please do right now, turn up this video and leave me a comment telling me what you like about this YouTube video. So I got a message from one of my subscribers a few days back, and she was like, Tovia, I have been meaning to ask you this question. Why did you stop making reaction videos? And I did reply out, but then I decided to just make a full video on it because I know a lot of you might be wondering why I stopped making reaction videos, even when those videos were actually doing so well. So why did I decide to stop? Now let's just dive into this video and make sure you watch it to the very end. So let's just talk about the reason I started making reaction videos at first. If you know me, when I created my YouTube channel, I wasn't making reaction videos. It was in 2020 that I actually started making reaction videos. Now, the reason why I started was I was filming one of these Facebook days. Like, I was just filming like this. And maybe I finished making that video, I received a notification, a YouTube notification. And on that notification, I saw someone reacting to Dimash Kuda Beijing. The instant I saw that video, I clicked and then I decided to watch it. When I watched it, trust me, I was amazed at the voice. I was like, who on earth is this person? Does it really exist? Is it humor? So I went on to do my research. I searched up Dimash Kuda Beijing. I saw a whole lot of his videos. I went to his YouTube channel and then I subscribed to see more of his songs. So because I was amazed, astonished by his voice, I decided to react to him so you all can hear it for yourself. Now that was why I started making reaction videos. So I made the first video and it got picked up. What I mean is it actually done better than every other videos on my YouTube channel. Aside the trending topics I made, so it actually did better than every other like normal topics. I was like, wow, okay, this is good. I love Dimash. I'm gonna do more because a lot of people commented and they were like, please react to another of Dimash song, please react to this, react to that. So that was when I started. And if you notice, I was only reacting to Dimash because I love his song. And I remember even sharing his videos to some of my Italian friends on his Italian song. So I shared with them to actually, and they was like, oh, this guy's great, he's amazing. Some already know him, but I never knew him until that very day. So that was why I started making reaction videos, and I continue until people started commenting and say, oh, please react to BTS, react to Diana Kudinova, react to K-pop, and all of that. Those requests were now coming, like a whole lot of requests, but I personally decided to stop making them, which I'm gonna be telling you guys the reasons why I stopped next. So this was why I started making reaction videos. And to tell you guys, all of my reaction videos did perfectly well. Like, they did really well. And making this reaction video also helped me grow my YouTube channel. So when I started, my YouTube channel was growing really well by making reaction videos. I did make a video just telling guys how you can get your 4,000 watch hours. You can also make reaction videos because this did help me grow as well. Now, moving to the reason why I stopped making reaction videos, which is the big question I love, you want to know. Why did you stop making reaction videos, Tovia, when your videos were getting all the views, getting all that you need? Why did you still stop? Calm down. You don't need to be in it. I'm going to tell you what actually stopped right now. The first reason why I stopped making reaction videos is because it doesn't require no skill. It makes me feel limited. I wasn't using my creativity no more. And I am not born to become a reactor. I am not born to sit down right now on my screen watching somebody else's video and then be giving opinion on them. That is not me. I cannot be limited to that. Am I sounding too harsh? Anyways, let me go down a little bit. Why I actually stopped was because I felt too limited to making reaction videos. Those days I was making it, let me tell you guys, I love music. You see me, that's part of me. One part of me is music. Music makes me happy. Music can actually make me smile even if I was angry or not feeling too well. Just by listening to good music, I will automatically just feel okay. So music is part of me. So just know right now, don't say, oh, she doesn't love music, that was why she stopped. I love music. It is a part of me. Music is my boyfriend, okay? Anyways, guys, like I said, I felt limited while I was making reaction videos. I am born to teach. I am born to lead. I am born to share with you guys, and I love to help. I love to share anything I know that is working. I love to give you guys tips. If this thing worked for me, I would love to share with you guys. And becoming a reactor, I cannot do that. I don't have that time to sit down watching other people's video and be telling them if they did well or not. Sorry, I don't have that time. I don't want to do that. That's not me. You don't get to explore, to be yourself when you're making reaction videos, except that's something you really enjoy. That's a niche you want to go to. You're good. I'm not against you, darling. This is me personally talking about myself, okay? But again, I am not against anyone doing it out there. If you want to do it to grow your YouTube channel, you'll find, darling. If you want to do it just for the fun for some time, you're free, darling. I'm not against anyone doing it. I'm just giving my own personal opinion, talking to my own personal self. So let me just tell you guys, I have over 5 videos that I have already filmed, edited. Most of them I've uploaded them, but they are all private. I never public them one day. I just sat down and was like, this is not me. I am not a reactor. I don't like this niche. This is not something I want to do. So I just left those videos there on my YouTube channel private, and I actually left the ones I have not uploaded, already edited. I just left them there. Most of them already deleted them. Most of them I just left them on my phone. So because this is not me, I love to teach. So I can't sit down always giving opinions on people's videos, if you know what I mean. So this was the reason I stopped making reaction videos. And like I told you guys before, I started because I found this amazing singer, which I do listen to his songs most times. I still go back to listen to his songs. So I think that is all I can do and not becoming a reactor on my YouTube channel. And I even plan, maybe later in the future, I am going to private all of the reaction videos on my YouTube channel currently, because I'm not a reactor. Now, another reason, this is not why I stopped, but I actually discovered this, although I was already making reaction videos even before I got monetized, but this is one thing I also discovered, and I thought I would tell most of you reactors, is reaction videos actually have lower CPM. Now, the reason for this is it is a popular video. It's like a whole lot of people are there just making it, and they get lots of views. Their CPM are so low. You don't get paid a whole lot for reaction videos, except you're getting thousands of views. So once your views are times by your RPM, you get to make lots of money. So that is what you get to enjoy if you're a reactor. So you just need lots of views, which you can easily get if you're serious with making reaction videos. So the niche is too popular, and there are a lot of people doing it, so the CPM is really low. Anyways, guys, that is it for this video. This is why I actually started making reaction videos, and this is why I decided to stop making reaction videos. I hope I have been able to answer those of you that are wondering or that have already asked me personally, asking me why you have stopped making reaction videos. So this is why. I wish you success on your YouTube channel, and keep grinding and grinding and grinding and grinding and grinding. No stop, okay? Anyways, I'll be seeing you guys on my next video. If you are yet to subscribe, please do it, and I love you, and take care of yourself. Bye.